Hey guys, it's GabbaVR, and now I will show you another powerful technique to remove people or other moving objects from a 360 photo using a smartphone. In one of my previous videos, I showed you a technique how to remove objects from symmetrical 360 photos easily with a free application and a smartphone. It was almost 6 months ago, and I was preparing a second episode to show you other cases when you can substitute a part of the image with another one and you need some other tricks. But I've got so many other topics that I always delayed it until I recently saw Ben Claremont releasing a video too in a similar topic. So I was a little bit sad that he stole the show, because I always want to show you techniques that other people haven't showed you before. I think it doesn't make sense to make the same video about the same things. So I just watched the video and finally calmed down, because I saw that he missed out the main thing I wanted to talk about. He mentioned Snapseed and another app with a healing brush tool, and then he switched to desktop. But in such a case, there's an easy way to continue on smartphone, and now I'll show you how. The basic idea of this editing technique is the same: taking multiple photos in the same location, standing still or using a tripod. But instead of transferring the files to the computer and back to the phone, we can edit them right on our mobile devices. In this case, I was shooting downtown and I wanted to capture this building with trams at the station. But on the street you can't control everything, and this time someone crossed the scene right here. But instead of waiting for another perfect moment, which might never have come, I just took another picture a couple of minutes later, right after the tram left the station. And I got this one. It looks horrible, except for a tiny detail that the view to that subway entrance is totally clear now. So now I will use this second shot to correct the first one. And good news, I don't have to copy anything to the computer, I can do it right on my phone. I open a free app called Photoshop Mix. I create a new project and open the first photo. This app allows me to play around with different photos on separate layers and to edit them just like in Photoshop. So tapping on the plus button, I open the second photo too. Pushing the thumbnails, I can drag and move the layers up and down. I make sure that my main photo is on the top, and then I start editing. I tap on the top layer and I can see that it's selected with a blue frame. Now I tap on the scissors icon to start masking. Activating the cutout function, I can choose between three different manual tools. Now I zoom in a little bit and select the basic tool. In the pop-up bar, I switch to the eraser brush, and tapping on the person I want to erase, I start drawing a mask. After I take my finger off the screen, I can see the final result. Actually, in this case, I can see the other layer underneath. Changing the preview mode, tapping on the layer icon on the top bar, now I can see this layer with a transparent background, so I can see what I exactly erased. Tapping on this layer icon again, the other layer becomes visible. Now I prefer this view, and I zoom in a little bit to refine the mask. As you can see, I erased some other people in the background, so I just fix it. I keep on working with the basic brush without switching to the eraser. This way I can bring back some erased parts of the image. And here you can see this area before and after. But since I started editing, I correct another part of the image too. I don't like those cars under the bridge, and I want to make it a little bit less busy. So I check out what's on the other layer under this area. I select the basic brush, then I switch to the eraser tool and start drawing on the screen until the car disappears. Zooming in, I can refine the mask again, switching between the eraser tool and the brush tool in the pop-up bar. Even more, I can play around with the hardness of the brush too. I tap on hardness and keep on moving my finger on the screen up and down. That's how I can set up the brush feather. With a harder brush, I can select things more accurately. And finally, I erase that white van too. Switching to the other preview mode on the top bar, I can see the mask and what I exactly erased from this layer. Tapping on the OK button in the right corner down there, I save these changes and switch back to the multi-layer view. Then tapping on the share button on the top bar, I can save the new image. Just like in Photoshop, it's a non-destructive process, so PS Mix will export a new copy of the edited files, leaving the original ones untouched. So here you can see all the three images. The original one, the one I used to correct my main photo, and finally here is the one I edited right on smartphone without wasting my time copying and editing the images on desktop. And besides having a nice 360 photo on the phone, I can play around with creating a little planet, inverted planet, or whatever I want to post on social media. With this technique you can even shoot in small rooms where there's nowhere to hide, one standing on one side, then on the other side of the camera, and finally you can easily mix the shots together to erase yourself from the photo. But of course there are so many further opportunities in multi-layer editing right on smartphone, so if you are interested about such mobile workflows, keep on following my YouTube channel. I will make a series focusing on smartphone editing with free applications. So if you are interested about more 360 contents and tutorials, subscribe to my YouTube channel and see you next time!